Do you know someone who hit their head and then started having some strange symptoms like dizziness, difficulty multitasking, trouble falling asleep, or developed panic attacks? Well, this person may have had a concussion. I am Dr. Andrea Furlan, a specialist in physical medicine and rehabilitation in Toronto, Canada. This video is a first of a four-part series. Today, I will explain what concussion is, what are the common symptoms, how to diagnose a concussion, and how long these symptoms persist. So, let's get started. Traumatic brain injuries, as the name suggests, are caused by trauma to the head. The trauma can be a bump, a blow, or jolt to the head, or by a hit to the body that causes the head and brain to move rapidly back and forth. It is interesting to note that the head does not need to hit anything to cause a TBI. Even a sudden acceleration and sudden deceleration, such as during a car crash, can cause TBI. Also, a blast or explosion can cause a TBI. The brain injury actually is the result from transfer of mechanical energy to the brain from external sources. A concussion is a type of traumatic brain injury or TBI. The diagnosis label concussion may be used interchangeably with mild TBI when an image of the brain is normal or it was not clinically indicated. Concussion is also a brain injury because it involves rapid movement of the brain tissue and the brain can swell up, can change shape, which can stretch and damage brain cells. Before, we used to think that concussion was a type of minor brain injury, but now we know that concussion also causes chemical and metabolic changes within the brain cells, making it more difficult to function and for the neurons to communicate with each other. Since the brain is the body's control center, the effects of a concussion can be far-reaching. Concussions are usually not life-threatening, but the effects of a concussion can change a life, and the injury should be treated seriously. On the other hand, when there is a bleeding or a fracture, the traumatic brain injury can lead to death. There are about 3 million TBI-related emergency visits and hospitalizations in the United States every year. The leading cause of all TBI-related emergency visits is falls, which accounts for 48% of visits. The second leading cause, with 17%, is being struck by or against an object. Injuries from a variety of sources, including accidents, abuse, blast exposure, and many more, can also cause concussions. What are the signs and symptoms of a concussion? The signs and symptoms of a concussion are incredibly important because a concussion doesn't show up on imaging like an X-ray, a CT, or an MRI scan. And there is no objective test like a drawing blood or saliva that can determine if a patient has a concussion. A doctor makes a concussion diagnosis based on the results of a mental and physical examination, which includes observing signs of concussion and the patient's reporting symptoms of concussion appearing after an impact to the head or the body. Concussion signs and symptoms are the brain's way of showing it is injured and not functioning normally. Concussion signs are what someone can see or observe to determine if the person has a concussion. Signs of a concussion range from obvious to more nuanced. But even one sign of a concussion after a hit to the head should be reported to a medical professional. Concussion signs include problems with balance, abnormal eye movements, amnesia, delay response to questions, forgetting an instruction, confusion about an assignment, or confusion of the game, scores, or opponent, inappropriate crying, inappropriate laughter, vomiting, and loss of consciousness. Concussion symptoms are what someone who is concussed will tell you they're experiencing. When responding to a possible concussion in a child, remember that a concussed child may not be able to clearly communicate the symptoms they are experiencing because of their age and limited vocabulary, and the fact that they have just experienced a brain injury. Concussion symptoms typically fall into four major categories. 1. Somatic or physical symptoms. Headache, blurry vision, dizziness, nausea, sensitivity to light, sensitivity to noise. 2. Cognitive symptoms. Difficulties with attention, memory problems, loss of focus, difficulty multitasking, difficulty completing mental tasks. 3. Sleep symptoms. Sleeping more than usual, sleeping less than usual, having trouble falling asleep. 4. Emotional symptoms. Irritability, anxiety, sometimes with panic attacks, depression. This is not an exhaustive list of concussion signs and symptoms, and it may take a few days for concussion symptoms to appear after the initial injury. How long these symptoms persist? Well, recovering from concussion means the brain cells must return to the normal function by rebalancing levels of chemicals like sodium, calcium, inside and outside of the cell. This process takes a lot of energy, so it is important to conserve energy during recovery. When properly managed, the majority of concussion symptoms will resolve within a couple of weeks. However, overexertion of brain cells during recovery can cause symptoms to persist for months or even years. It is estimated that between 10% and 30% of concussion patients suffer from extended recovery, known as post-concussion syndrome. This is the first video on a series of videos about concussions. Stay tuned for future videos about treatments of concussion, exercises, what to do about headaches, and mental health issues after a concussion. This video was done in collaboration with Concussion Legacy Foundation, a charity organization based in the United States with chapters in Australia, Canada, and the UK. If you want to learn more about concussions, visit the website concussionfoundation.org. And remember, this video is not medical advice. If you think you have a concussion, please talk to a healthcare professional. If there is an emergency, please go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. This video is for educational purposes only. Share this video with anyone that might need this information. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.